Gregory Peck,
Judy Garland,
Bill Powell, and Myrna Loy.
Errol Flynn.
Ford. Hawks.
Fantastic director.
Best role that I ever had.
Loved every minute of it.
Dad. You're my father. I'm your son. I love you. I always have, and I always will. But you think of yourself as a colored man. I think of myself as a man.
In some ways, cinematically, Sidney Poitier was required to do precisely what Jackie Robinson did in baseball a generation earlier.
As a child coming up, there was very few African-American stars, and it was always just one. Sidney Poitier was the one.
Sidney Poitier would establish the height to which we can rise.
Poitier in the 60s is this big star, and he's the only dramatic black actor who works continually in these leading roles. And he has big films.
Not just what you do up there, little old Pennsylvania, earn that kind of money.
I'm a police officer.
I remember he did a movie called Brother John, and it was a character that was really fascinating to me, and where he just comes into a town, he's got this suitcase and a passport that has China and all these different things on it. I remember as a young kid being, wow, it's amazing.
Of all the Poitier movies, I've seen just about everything. It's one film of his, this film called Brother John. I think it was his best performance ever in that picture. It wasn't a big hit like a lot of his movies, but it was something about that performance that was so riveting and genuine that I wanted to be a better person.
He's such a brilliant actor, but I think there was a humanity inside of him that really struck you so strongly.
At that time, there was a social need for a character like Sidney Poitier. The social changes that were being wrought by the civil rights movement was demanding a different kind of conversation and interaction and introspection on the part of black and white people in America at that time. Sidney Poitier's characterizations on screen were part of that conversation, and they were a necessary part of that conversation.
What the hell is going on here?
This doesn't make sense either.
Well, I told you, didn't I?
What did you tell him? Look, Chris, if you don't explain to me in the next few minutes what you three are playing at...
I can explain it, Mr. Drake.
You can? Well, let's have it.
Well, it's my fault. See, we have a sort of a situation here.
But there is criticism that comes from within the black community about his characters. And guess who's coming to dinner? There you have this, it's supposed to be a full-fledged treatment of interracial love. How can you have a movie about interracial love? The two never kiss. Except there's one little kiss where you see them through the rearview mirror of a taxi cab. And you say, well, yeah, I guess that's what's going on. He wants to marry this young white woman. He won't do it unless her family, her father, basically gives permission. They, in a sense, acknowledge that interracial romance exists. And I think Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, they felt they were being daring, but they kept the safeguards there.
I know it's easy now to be very dismissive of some of the characters. Oh, Sidney was isolated because he had to be the perfect, you know, stalwart, asexual black character in an otherwise white film who, you know, was always saving someone.
Here, let me...
You know, with the criticism of Poitier was that he was the good Negro there at the service of whites. Even his movie, you know, Lilies of the Field, where he wins that Oscar, he's helping those dizzy white nuns build their chapel. Possibly his strongest screen performance is in A Raisin in the Sun, the 1961, where, you know, we sing with Ruby Dee and Dinah Sands and Claudia McNeil. He wasn't even nominated for that. In The Heat of the Night, which is a very strong performance, and that no one has ever forgotten. I'm now talking about the black audience when he says, they call me Mr. Tibbs.
Virgil, that's a funny name for a nigger boy that comes from Philadelphia. What do they call you up there?
They call me Mr. Tibbs.
Then when a white character slaps him and he slaps him back.
Was Mr. Colbert ever in this greenhouse, say last night about midnight?
And the black audience wanted this from Sidney. It didn't get it enough. And the thing is that, you know, in the 60s, the civil rights movement evolves into the Black Power movement. And now a new generation wants a grittier hero.
Sidney Poitier makes John Shaft as a movie presence possible. He makes Superfly possible, as well as he makes Denzel Washington and Denzel Washington's different numbers of characters possible. He makes Sam Jackson possible, Morgan Freeman possible, Wesley Snipes possible, Will Smith possible, Martin Lawrence possible. All of that happens because at the very beginning, there was this more than perfect black actor named Sidney Poitier.